Of course, it's a long-range forecast, so we'll just cross our fingers for now.
I will say it is looking a little bit cold, perhaps Thanksgiving week, but
well,
you know,
gets you in the spirit.
It is, yeah, and so, but things could change too. So I was like, we just don't want it to be cold rain like we had a couple
right.
of years ago.
That was pretty bad.
And that's what we have outside right now, Jenny. This is the first of three fronts that will impact us. We've got another one on Wednesday. We have another one somewhere Friday into Saturday afternoon. Let's take care of this one first. 40 right now, Indy, 35 Lafayette, 39 in Richmond. And yeah, we told you it was going to be a wet day, and that certainly played out. Now, mixing in with some of this generally a cold rain, but where you see some of those reds and oranges on live Doppler 13 radar, picking up perhaps on a few flakes of snow, maybe a few sleet pellets here. This is more of a novelty than anything. All of this will start to wrap up here by 9 or 10 o'clock as this front and its system, the area low pressure with it, starts to move toward the east. Here in the Indianapolis, we've got northwest wind at 9. That pushes our wind chill values close to the freezing mark. Now, temperatures overnight tonight aren't going to drop too much because of this layer of cloud cover, but what you will encounter later tonight, early tomorrow morning, and this means for the kids at the bus stop as well, there's going to be some drizzle, a little low cloudiness. It is not going to be a very bright start tomorrow the way it looks, and it's certainly going to be a cold start. They're going to need the winter gear here in the morning. Temperatures in the 30s are going to be slow to warm up because the clouds hang tough even through your lunch hour. Heading home from work and school, at least partial sunshine, but not expecting a whole lot. I mean, but we'll take whatever we can get at this point. As we get into the afternoon, temperatures topping out at about 43 degrees, but the wind is going to be coming at about 5 to 10, so it won't necessarily feel that warm. Now, again, you'll see this cloud layer hanging tough through the noon hour. We'll stop it at 4 p.m. There will be some breaks for some sunshine here, but what will happen tomorrow night into Tuesday morning is that we're going to see another batch of low clouds developing, and the fog Tuesday morning, because we do clear out briefly, we may be a little worse here. So a couple of mornings where we may have some visibility issues to deal with. And then what we'll be following after Tuesday afternoon is the second cold front that brings rain with it heading into your Wednesday here. So Wednesday is going to be very similar to today, maybe just a little bit warmer here. The third front could be, well, definitely should be the strongest of the three. The exact timing on this is still to be determined, so it's possible if it holds off until Saturday, we may have to bump that high Saturday, or if it comes in Friday afternoon, Saturday could be much colder. But we do want you to know there's going to be a lot of wind associated with this third front. Can't rule out some damaging wind. We'll have to kind of wait and see on the timing of this. But one thing is for sure, that third front is going to bring in another shot of well below normal temperatures. In fact, highs next Sunday will only be in the 30s. So a little chilly bout. Let's get it out to Jason Spells now.